Learning about GM technology is very confusing. Some people say it's dangerous, and some say it's great. But we're getting nowhere by flinging articles at each other on the internet. So let's take a look at what's actually going on. Long ago, humans began to cultivate wild plants, which have since mutated to have some fantastic traits. Traits are due to tiny biochemical machines inside cells, and every species contains a different complement of each. We call these proteins, the blueprints for which are encoded in the DNA in segments called genes. When genes mutate, plants produce different proteins and so have different traits. Long before GM technology, we had clever ways to create new crops with better traits by messing with their DNA, and by fiddling with their genomes, we've developed unnatural but wonderful foods. We've often done this by blasting their DNA with chemicals or radiation, causing thousands of random mutations throughout their genomes, but this is considered organic, not genetic modification. Genetic modification is used for upgrading a specific trait for which a specific protein is required. Mutation is unlikely to create the gene necessary, although usually it already exists somewhere. Breeding is the easiest way to transfer the gene we need, but often the gene will be in an incompatible genome, and so despite our best efforts, until recently the trait would have remained impossible to upgrade. Today, we're able to accurately copy the gene's DNA sequence and insert it directly into our crop's genome. This is far less disruptive than traditional mutation, which itself is an attempt to create these useful genes. The plant is then tested to make sure all proteins are functioning okay and that there's no harmful new ones. Then finally, the upgraded crop is ready to compete in the seed market, except it doesn't. Whereas mutated crops go to market, many bureaucracies prohibit GMOs, citing safety concerns. Most people are convinced this must be to protect us, but there's often other motives for these restrictions. Besides, if inbreeding, crossing, irradiating, poisoning, or otherwise mutating entire genomes is considered safe, how can manually inserting a specific gene possibly be considered dangerous? In many places today, the poor are suffering from vitamin A deficiency due to a lack of beta-carotene in their diets. Some crops can be hybridized to produce beta-carotene, however, rice unfortunately isn't one of them. Rice is a staple food for much of the world, but is missing two of the proteins needed to make beta-carotene. In the 90s, work began on filling these gaps with the hope of eventually eliminating the disease. The missing genes were found in daffodil and soil bacterium genomes, and this new crop was called golden rice. However, the amount of beta-carotene it produced was a little low, so the scientists continued their work. By 2005, the daffodil gene had been replaced with the corn version, increasing beta-carotene 23 times. This was a breakthrough in the fight against vitamin A deficiency, but it's not gone smoothly. Vitamin A deficiency kills more people annually than HIV, or malaria and tuberculosis combined, many of who are under 5. That is, every 20 seconds, on average, a child dies. Golden rice was made free to farmers in 2001, but due to intense lobbying, it's yet to reach them. Activists will tell you that golden rice is scary, but let's instead really try to break this down. DNA is a code containing only 4 letters, and genes are simply lots of these letters in a sequence. A specific gene is an instruction to build a specific protein, and it's the proteins that make life happen. We frequently use mutagenesis to artificially change the letters in our crop's genomes, hoping to improve them. But today, genetic modification takes the randomness out of it, giving us any crops we want. In the future, genetic technologies have the potential to revolutionize our lives, and understanding the complexity of DNA will likely be amongst our greatest technological achievements thus far. But we're a naturally cautious species whose brains are actually hardwired to believe the worst about almost anything. This makes it very easy to exploit people by telling the scariest stories, which is why so many people do. Everything in this universe has some risk attached, and it's up to each of us to judge what risks we'll each accept. However, it appears that modification is inherently safer than mutation, and that's been working great for us. Some people still won't believe modified products are safe, and that's fine. Stores label food for them organic. But some people are demanding things they don't want to buy be labeled, which may quite quickly become problematic. Since agriculture first began, we've randomly changed our crop's DNA. The A, G, C's and T's. Today we can do the same thing, but carefully, to create the plants that we need. Whilst this is an interesting debate, for thousands every day, this isn't simply an academic issue. Although genetics is complicated, it's not magic, and transgenics isn't voodoo.